Philippines unemployment rate fell in the third quarter, but now it's up again as seasonal summer jobs end. Here's Catherine Ferrer reporting from Spain.
Spain's unemployment rate fell in the third quarter from the second. Data showed on Thursday, October 24, giving a lift to the country's dire labor market. The unemployment rate between July and September was 26%, with some 5.9 million people out of work, according to the National Statistics Institute said. Joblessness has soared in Spain since a property bubble burst in 2008 and the country entered a five-year economic slump. Spain has the second highest unemployment rate in the 17-country bloc after Greece.
But I think there's a big gap between what is the statistical, technical end of the recession and a genuine improvement in the lives of families and a genuine improvement for companies.
Mariano Rajoy's center-right government has slashed public spending. He said this will bring Spain's deficit under control. For Professor Thompson, austerity measures together with failure to increase internal demand will not improve the situation.
I don't see how that's going to make the economy more competitive simply because you're continuing with the ongoing austerity. I think that that's going to make the situation worse for families in Spain, worse for small and medium companies in Spain, and as a result, internal demand is still going to struggle to grow, because at the moment it's not growing, it's actually shrinking. And what the politicians really need is for the economy in Spain to be growing in terms of internal demand, and that's just not happening at the moment.
According to Thursday's data, some 3.2 million unemployed have been out of work for a year or more. There are just over 1.8 million households in which all members are unemployed, deepening inequality in the region. In the education sector to protest against larger classes, bigger workloads for teachers and higher fees. Protesters said the new policies reduce access to education as well as the quality of education. With unemployment still stubbornly high, protesters say that young people are also struggling to study because of the sheer cost of going to university. Reporting from Madrid, Spain, this is Catherine Ferrer for Eagle News.